Hello. We are the members of the Kumu Youth Club. I'm Gert.
I'm Ingrid.
I'm Helen.
And I'm Ramona.
Our presentation will be in four parts, and Helen will start.
Okay, as the youth club member who participated in the Museum as Toolbox online survey, which Alexandra was talking before, I'm gonna talk a bit about what we had to do for the survey and also how I see the popularity of art museum among the youngsters. First, I would like to start with the survey, which was probably the most extensive survey I have ever done. One particular thing about this survey was that we had to give a lot of reviews. There were pictures about the architecture and the interiors of different museums and also exhibitions. We had to point out what we liked or what we didn't like about them. It was easier to spontaneously comment on the architecture and interiors, but I became hesitant when I was asked to judge the exhibitions and the artworks. At this point, I really felt that I had too less context. The questions and the tasks in the survey in general were mostly understandable and clear. I also liked that I had the opportunity to skip some questions and come back to them later, because it would have been really hard to answer for all these questions, which required a very profound answer in a row. When talking about the duration of the survey that lasted for 3 weeks, it sure was enough time for answering the questions, but it was not enough time for creating a deep discussion between participants in forum. I think one of the reasons was that all the participants didn't visit at the site every day, so perhaps it would have been more successful if the discussion and communication part had occurred on a more common social platform. Now about the popularity of the museums. Although the youngsters who participated in the Translocal project visited the art museum almost every day during the artist residency, statistics say that young people normally don't visit museums much. Students from elementary school, for example, have a more positive attitude towards museums, as museums are often visited during a school day with the class. The familiar lessons always seem way more boring than educational trips to museums. I believe that success of a museum visit greatly depends on how well the topic of the exhibition is explained. It means that a guide with a good storytelling skills can often be a reason why some of the students might be interested in visiting the museum again by their own. Art students and young people who are more into arts and culture might find their way to art museum more often. They usually are already in contact with other people who also love art, and in this way they can access the information about exhibitions and art events that interest them more easily. But for youngsters who are outside of this community, it's way harder to find or stumble upon this information. Sometimes, even if they know about the humans, they might still not go there because they have a feeling that these events are only for a close-knit art community and they would feel themselves like intruders when they go there. And for the last, even young people who are not that much into art will still go to an art museum when they are traveling abroad. There they find famous art museums with famous paintings inside and they make selfie with the iconic paintings. And they don't mind waiting half an hour in a queue for these pictures. So inclusion, everyone appreciates art in a way.
How do we get young people to visit museums for more than just a selfie here in Estonia? In Kumu, we, the Kumu Youth Club, are the superheroes solving this issue by day.
And saving the world by night.
So, born in the spring of 2015, Kumu Youth Club is the baby of Kumu's public programs creator, Marianne Dalvisto. She got inspiration from other museums such as Tate, MoMA, Centre Pompidou in Paris, and Reina Sofia's Art Centre in Madrid. The club started with about 15 members, and although we have welcomed new members a couple of times already, we have also had some casualties, and our total headcount stays at about 15. The aim of our club has been to open the museum up to a wider audience. And what better way to get youngsters visiting museums than have them organizing events there themselves? We became a part of Kumu and visited regularly. There once was a week where I spent 6 out of 7 days in Kumu. But not all youngsters think museums are interesting. Changing that prejudice is a journey, and one super awesome event is not going to make all young people love museums all of a sudden. That is why we are conquering Mount Youth one step at a time. First, our own friends, who we invite to the museum constantly, not even for events, but to all the exhibitions we see as well. I've noticed that I tell my friends more about Kumu than new movies at the cinemas, for example. Secondly, the youth who are into body art. We have held workshops on face painting, temporary tattoos, and henna at our events. For fantasy lovers, we have held a comic workshop. Also, we've made and installed 2 ping pong tables in the Kumu courtyard, and our events that take place there always have a small ping pong tournament as well. We've attracted people to listen to experimental music with performances from Mim Project, Fernando Lira, and Willem Jaho. We have thought of science-loving youngsters, as we had a whole youth day devoted to Ryoji Ikeda's installation Supersymmetry, which is deeply rooted in physics. We have had several events for drawers, drop-in drawing studios at Ons Leikmas and Soviet Impressionism exhibitions. And our last event, held in the beginning of August, was aimed at raising awareness about the vegan lifestyle among youth. As our youth club has always had at least one vegan member, we've held multiple vegan picnics so they could share their wisdom and tasty recipes with others. Of course, there are a bunch of other people with different interests we still have not thought about, but we've made a start. To summarize, I think the key to getting youth to a museum is not necessarily changing what the museum is showing, but showing youth that the museum is hiding gems they would find precious. Now, to succeed on our quest, we need communication, among the youth group members as well as with the youth we are trying to invite here. For this, we use different communication tools. Open to the widest audience are our Facebook page and Instagram account. On the Facebook page, we post about our doings, as well as general art and culture-related posts and articles we find interesting. It is the place where we advertise our events and share pictures of them. And as visuals are everything in this day, And age, our Instagram account is also an important tool. We post regularly about what we are up to and have created a hashtag, #NoRatKumus, meaning youth in Kumu, to get people to share pictures they have taken in Kumu as well. In addition to that, we also use posters to spread the word and invite people to our events. We design a poster for most of our bigger events and put them up in schools. For the inside communication among the youth club members, we have created a closed Facebook group where we share info about our meetings, talk about the details of our events, choose pictures for our albums, and so on. We also have a group chat on Messenger, which is used for less serious matters. Our youth days, workshops, drawing studios, and other events, as well as getting information about them to our peers, is what makes up most of our work. The Toolbox project, although, has been a bit different.
For us, the Kumu Youth Club Museum as Toolbox project started in spring 2016. Although Alexandra already covered this, what is Toolbox for us? It's a project focused on youngsters in different parts of Europe. It examines how do we understand the concept of a contemporary art museum, do we find museums interesting, and how can an artist, Luigi Coppola, make a contemporary artwork with us, and us being about 12 members of the Kumu Youth Club. Luigi's residency consisted of three parts. First being that we practiced for the shooting of the photos. Secondly, we made costumes for the shooting of the photos. And lastly, we shot the photos. Luigi's residency lasted only a week, so keep in mind that we had limited time resources. To document the process, we made a Weebly blog and posted there regularly. For example, Luigi made us do some rather obscure exercises to bond and break the ice at first. For example, so pretty much those were our first days. Then we started to exercise for the shooting of the photos. For example, we had to walk in a spiral, just walk in a spiral. At first it was confusing. I didn't realize at all how were the exercises supposed to help us prepare for the final shooting. And what I heard from others, they were just as confused as I was. But days went by and we got used to Luigi's methods and progress was made. We had to communicate a lot with each other, and it really showed us how different our ideas and views can be. To be on the same page with Luigi was often difficult, as we had different cultural background, and it played a big role in our communication process. We would understand some things really differently, but it made it all more interesting. I think because of that, we had more opinions, and more opinions is always good. Most of the Kumu Youth Club members participated in the project, although not all as actively as ideal. But still, I feel that we all came a bit closer during the project and we could really feel the solidarity. All in all, it was a great experience, especially if you were to continue with making contemporary art works in the future, or you would like to study art in college or university. We also had our youth club member Ingrid make a summary of the residency, a small video.
Okay. So, you're definitely interested in what's going to happen with the Toolbox project next. And if you aren't, well, I'm going to tell you about it anyway. What's amazing for us about this project is that it's a work in progress and it keeps you occupied. For example, after the residency was over, we continued working on the catalogue for this project. In order to find ideas for the design of the catalogue, we visited a small bookstore called Lugamik. It's also a publishing house. Well, that were the slides that were supposed to be there, but weren't. Technical difficulties, that's okay. Basically, this bookstore has lots of art and design themed publications, and we scouted around and took pictures of everything we liked about them. For example, fonts, color schemes, layouts, textures, everything like that. And based on our discoveries and brainstormings, Tuuli Aule, who's the designer for this catalogue, has more ideas for the design of the catalogue. During this process, we will have more meetings with her to keep us on track. The catalogue is meant to cover all of the project, as well as the upcoming exhibition. And as mentioned before today, every single museum that takes part in Translocal Museum's Toolbox will have its own exhibition. And ours will take place in April 2017. It will feature all of the works from this project, and we will also work with Kumu's curator, Triin Tulgiste, to find art pieces from Estonian Art Museum's collection that would be complementary to them. It would definitely be interesting to see the actual outcome of all we did a year after the residency. We were also looking for a good communication platform that would bring the content closer to other youngsters as well, as we love making videos, and we have noticed that they get a lot of feedback and reach more people. It only seemed logical to create a YouTube channel to document it all. So we are really happy that Toolbox will have its own YouTube channel on which all of the participating youth clubs can start posting and sharing their experience. Again, as mentioned before, we will have videos of the preparation processes for the exhibitions, as well as other activities, and also during the exhibitions, we can document our events and talks. We are really hoping that this YouTube channel will go beyond Translocal Museum's Toolbox, and it will stay active even after the project has come to an end. So this way, it would become a video diary and a communication space for ourselves. Now, Translocal aside, in September, we are welcoming new members to our family, so a large part of our time will be occupied with that. We have talked a lot about the success of our events, but in reality, it's never been that easy. And it's been quite a complicated journey to reach comprehension and agreement among us. We've had our letdowns and members who don't maybe take this as seriously as we would wish. We're also losing a few of our hardworking members this year because they're moving to a different city or even flying across the globe for a youth exchange. And young people usually have a lot of hobbies and interests and this certain volatility about them, but we're still developing, so that's completely okay and there's nothing wrong with that. But what's good about Kumu Youth Club is that it has always been based on the fact that it's completely voluntary. No one forces you to do anything, so it also grows the sense of dutifulness. So we're really hoping to find people who bring something new to our club and feel passionate about it. So if anyone here would like to spread the word, then we would be extremely grateful for it. And we will promise to give the new members a very, very warm welcome. and you can soon find information about it on our Facebook page. The first upcoming event in which we will start working with the new members will take place in October. And it's another youth evening in Kumu, but this time it also ties in with the programs of Tallinn Youth Week, Tallinn Noorte Nädal, and Children and Youngsters Festival, Avatud Mänguväljad, open playgrounds, basically. We will have a nice little evening here in Kumu with exhibition tours, workshops, break music, and talks with young entrepreneurs, as this year Tallinn Youth Week is focused on design-loving and venturesome youth. Lastly, something we're incredibly excited about, we finally have our official logo, and we had a lot of different ideas, but in the end, Creative Studio saved the day and came up with something playful, versatile, and just the right amount of professional. So here it is. That's us. Thank you for listening.